Start by choosing File, New Project, Create, or pressing Ctrl-N. Then manually adjust your image dimensions, starting palette, color depth, and more, or choose from the pre-made configurations which match the technical constraints of classic computers and video game consoles. Double-click the initial layer to rename it. Click the Add a New Animation Layer button to create additional layers so you can edit elements such as background, foreground, or character and object art independently. Hold the left mouse button and drag layer names to change the Z order of the layers. Lock the layers you're not currently working on to make sure you don't accidentally draw parts of one element on the layer of another. Left-click to select any color in the color palette and click the basic drawing tool icon or press the D key to start drawing on your selected layer. Click the current brush size box to reveal the size slider so you can quickly change the size of your working brush, or hold shift and press the plus or minus keys to enlarge or shrink the brush. You can also click the pen tab in the tool and paint settings section to enable brush size or other features to be controlled via stylus pressure. Just press the period key whenever you want to get back to drawing with a single pixel. While drawing, the left mouse button adds the color you have selected while the right button erases or draws with the background color you have selected by right-clicking on a color in the color palette. Right-clicking on the small checkerboard pattern box here lets you make sure the right mouse button erases from the current layer instead of adding a selected color. Click the pipette tool or press the comma key to select a color from the artwork. Left-click on an on-screen color to set your drawing color, or right-click to set your background or erasing color. Click the Get Brush icon and click and drag to instantly grab anything on the current layer as a brush to draw with. Doing this with the left mouse button leaves the original art intact. Using the right mouse button will cut the art that you're picking up off of the layer. Right-clicking the Grab Brush icon and choosing Freehand, or holding Alt and pressing B will allow you to freehand select your brush instead of using a rectangular selection. Left-clicking to draw your selection shape results in grabbing the brush while leaving the original art on the layer. Using the right mouse button to create your selection outline will result in cutting the art from the layer while picking it up. If the art you're trying to grab as a brush is completely surrounded with the background color or empty pixels, select the magic wand method or hold Ctrl and press M, then just click once on the art. Left click to grab a copy, right click to cut it from the layer while grabbing it as a brush. If you right click on any box in the brush container section, you can store your currently grabbed brush for later use. Just left click on its thumbnail in the brush container to pick it back up. Now hold shift and press either the plus or minus keys to perfect the size of your brush. Press the X key or Y key to horizontally or vertically flip it, or hold shift and press Z to go into freehand brush stretching mode, and just hold and drag the left mouse button and release the button when you achieve the desired size and shape. Zoom in using the middle mouse wheel, the plus and minus keys, or by pressing the M key. Press the period key to get back to drawing with a single pixel and start to refine each individual element. Now start to use unbroken lines to separate key components and the flood fill tool, which you can also access with the F key to fill those areas with the desired colors. Click any color in the palette and use the sliders in the section below the color palette to tweak or completely change any color index. Notice how if you change the color from an index that's used in your project, every pixel which uses that color instantly changes. Use the line, rectangle, and ellipse tools when you need to quickly create straight lines and other basic shapes. You can press the V, R, and C keys respectively to access each of those drawing modes. Now that you know the basic tools and workflow, continue to refine the details, shading, and color of each element of your project until it's finished. Be sure to save frequently along the way, and to save separate backups so you can always revert back to older versions if needed or desired. Now that you're comfortable with these basic features, select File, Keyboard Shortcuts, and examine or change the feature hotkeys in order to discover more features and to optimize your workflow. Type in keywords like color and size in the filter box to make finding the key combinations for specific features a breeze. Click any key command you want to change, then click in the Shortcut Edit box at the bottom left and type the key or key combination you'd like to change it to. then click OK. We've only scratched the surface of what you'll be capable of with ProMotion. Keep an eye out for more videos which will cover more advanced features and workflow. And don't forget, you can choose Help Contents or Help Search for further documentation of specific features. Thank you for watching and happy creating!